Hello everyone, welcome to Liberable. This is the VW Golf Club Sport S. Can't believe I'm saying that. Thank you so much to Maui, the owner of this car. He actually gave me this car to use for the weekend so I can see what this car is like. I hope you like Frankenstein's creation microphone going on over here. My previous microphone I used packed up, so I'm improvising today. Okay guys, so what is a VW Golf Club Sport S? It's the two-door version of the Club Sport. However, the Club Sport S is totally reworked. You're talking aluminium subframe. The rear seats have been removed, but I'm going to show you all of that now. So let me take you quickly around this car and just show you some of the features on this car, and we'll take it from there. As you can see, two-door Golf GTI, a first for South Africa. We didn't really get two-door Golfs here by us. They put this bar across here for body rigidity. No spare wheel, no back seats. Even the sound insulation here at the back has gone. So a lot of work is done to reduce weight. Apparently this reduces over 30 kilograms on this car. This is VW's E888 engine. In the Club Sport S state of tune, it produces 228 kilowatts. It produces even more power with a short burst with the overboost function. You can see here, no sound deadening. They even did that to reduce weight. Underneath all this, right, is a aluminium subframe which reduces a huge amount of weight. The Club Sport S also has a 6-speed manual gearbox, and I think you could probably say, why not DSG? Well, if they had to go with a DSG gearbox, it would have been 30 kilos heavier. I know this is funny, right? They even put a smaller battery in it to reduce weight. It's freaking insane. Other interesting facts of the E888 engine, we've got variable valve lift on the exhaust cam. I can't properly hear it, but I wasn't listening for it. Now I'll try and see if I can hear it while we're driving. We've got 8 injectors behind the intake and direct injection. So a lot of people think that the 8 injectors is like for more performance. What the 8 injectors actually does is, they have to have injectors before the valves to keep the valves clean, and they have direct injectors also for more pressure, so they have a high pressure fuel pump on the cam drive with these engines. I hope I'm right. You guys can correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. See these brake covers? They are aluminium, reducing about some would say about a kilo or two of unsprung weight on each wheel to keep the car just more sturdy around the corner. Another interesting part here with the Club Sport is this redevised front bumper. We got a huge air dam over here for the intercooler, and I think that is the oil cooler. And we have these gills over here which feed air over the wheel to streamline the car down the side. What's also interesting is you see this active aero. You see the splitter here in front and the rear spoiler there at the back. Let me see if I can show you that quickly. Apparently, these features on this car can actually produce downforce. We're talking around 12, 13 kilos at the back and say 7, 8 kilos in the front. So it's actually helped VW to plant this car even more around the bend. So yeah, okay, so let's go for a drive with this car and let's get you guys some exhaust clips and let's talk about what this car is like. So I'm so sorry if I was a bit too formal in the opening of this video. I'm just so excited, but I also wanted to talk to you guys very seriously about this car's price tag. They are fetching now for around a bar here in Cape Town, South Africa, and it's because of what this car did around the Nürburgring. Now, a very famous magazine and YouTube channel in Europe called Evo actually had this car with a lot of supercars in their shoot. I can see why. This car feels fantastic to drive. We're coming downhill. Let me see if I can get down quickly over here. So if you feel this bend, you can actually get hot into the bend, and the car just tugs you. It's insane how this car feels in a corner because it's so communicative. The steering wheel, there's decent amount of feel, definitely not a huge amount. The gearbox is not as good as a Civic Type R's, to be honest with you. I've always maintained Honda makes some of the best manual gearboxes out there, and I don't think this gearbox can compete there. However guys, the way this car makes you feel, fantastic. It's so dynamic. We have 235, 35, 19s on the score. Wrapped in Michelin Pilot Sport 4S's. These are the same bloody tires they're running on supercars. And I don't think they come cheap. I'm not going to put my foot down so hard in first gear because this car's clutch is a bit iffy. So you guys will probably hear a bit of clutch slip here and there, like. Okay, now we have no clutch slip, but here and there I'll pick up some clutch slip depending on where the revs is. So there was only 47 VW Club Sport S's brought to South Africa. All were sold immediately. There are 400 in the world. This is number 371 of 400. So yeah, this car is fetching for quite a bit of money. Is it the best hatchback I've ever driven? Is it better than the Civic Type R? Okay, my top three looks like this. It was Renault Megane RS in first place. It was a Honda Civic Type R in second. And third place, I had the, I think that was the only two. I didn't have a third yet. This car goes straight in number one. Gents, it's so dynamic. Ladies and gents, it's so fun and playful and serious at the same time. This, I can't believe it. I'm quiet because it's so unbelievable. So communicative and oh, my brother's laughing next to me.
You feel that?
Okay. I'm gonna go cool down now, but I'm speechless, guys. The feeling when you're in a corner, the communication between the front end, the back end, I didn't feel it going light at all. I even tried lifting off in certain bends just to feel the weight transfer from the back to the front, and nothing. Flipping out. My jacket off because I was sweating. I just did a full wiki for you guys to hear what it sounds like. My brother himself is shocked at the back because I didn't think that this car was gonna feel the way it felt. So dynamic, it's so fast. 228 kilowatt and 300 odd newton meters plus 380. Go away, fly. 380 plus newton meters of torque. But the way it puts that power down and the way the limited slip diff works with you rather than against you. Unbelievable! It feels supercar like. It looks better than a Civic Type R. It goes better. Go away, fly, man. Yo guys, the flight is annoying. If this car is so impressive, let's hop into something rather special. Let's hop into a club sport that's modified by CPI Performance. Yasin from CPI's VW Golf Club Sport Mach 7, and it is slightly tweaked. We've got a custom file on the car. Obviously CPI tuning is all custom files, so Yasin basically writes their own files for the cars, and this car is making just over 280 kilowatt. It is incredibly powerful, and being a club sport, you've got some nice, you know, the active things over here. You've got the different, the blacked out mirrors, the little rear wing. I think, come have a look. Get the same wing that you get on the Club Sport S over here as well. However, you have back doors, so this car obviously is not as light as a normal Golf Club Sport S that's got the cage here at the back and all the stuff stripped out. So yeah, this is basically the Breakhats Golf GTI. So let's go for spinning this car, see what it's like, and then conclude the video. Okay, now that I'm behind the wheel of Mr. Yasin from CPI's VW Golf Club Sport, this is the four-door version. As I said in the opening part of this half of the video, this car's got some work done to it. We've just got things like cold air intake, we've got a stage one file, and some other odds and ends. The car's making, say, just over 280 kilowatt. It's not like a balls to the wall club sport. However, 280 kilowatt or there and thereabouts is not a small number. This car is also dropped to the floor, so it's gonna wheel spin. Yeah, like crazy. And this is a club sport, so what you guys must understand about the club sport is it's a four-door version of the two-door car. That's not true. The club sport is basically a better version of the Golf GTI, although it still has the EA 888 engine with the overboost function, so it can make Golf R kilowatt at overboost for only 10 seconds. That's very interesting. Do you hear the lift? There. You can't really hear it. I hope it's coming out of the microphone. But yeah, it will overboost for 10 seconds and you'll make just basically 220, say 218 kilowatt. So it's a good start, and that means getting big numbers out of this motor is really easy. Another thing with this car is the suspension is not Club Sport S. Club Sport S is a proper balls to the wall track car. It's got a cage at the back, there's no back seats, it's a two-door. So this is like the fashion version of that car, basically. The result is a car that is actually, or this particular car, although the suspension is a bit stiff, this car is very, very fast. Second gear. Yeah. It's just wheel spinning, squabbling for traction. And this is on Toyo R888s, eh? Check this corner, for example, third gear. The car actually went wide because of the amount of power it's got. It's like overwhelming the front wheels. The camera like fell out in between my brother's legs. But yeah, first gear. I'm gonna put the dash control off quickly. Battle to put power down on this car, but this car did a 12.4 second quarter mile. I mean, how stupid is that number? 12.4 seconds front wheel drive Golf. I think it just boils again down to this platform EA888 coupled with this XDS front differential. It's Oh guys, I'm blown away by this car. It's not the club sport S, and I don't think it is the club sport S. VW is just playing on the club sport brand, I think, with this car. Not a problem, not a problem at all. Mr. Alan Jacobs in the Golf R did a 10.4 second quarter mile, courtesy of CPI. And I said in that video, and I'll stand by what I said in that video, Yasin from CPI definitely knows what he's doing with these cars. I mean, these guys are proving the numbers. Everybody who I know who's been there and who's going there is so impressed with the quality of performance they get from their cars. I can't go too hot here because here's a bump in the road, so I've just go super easy of it. I am in second gear. Let's put the traction control back on again. This is another man's car. Duff is having a hell of a hard time with all this power, to be honest with all of you. But oh, that actually hurts the way this thing comes out of a corner. It hurts my soul. Okay, first gear again. Worried about the lower suspension, it's but yo. Insane steering feel. It's not again as precise as the club sport is. It's a little bit more GTI-y, but that, you know, it's GTI, it's not a problem. But club sport is it's just that extra bit more special and a bit more purposeful. This car again, the power is, I think, what's boggling my mind here. It's, every time I drive those cars, I'm so impressed by them. It's unbelievable what these guys are getting to do with these cars, especially all these different tuning companies. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. I thoroughly enjoyed making it for you. The VW Golf Club Sport and VW Golf Club Sport S here on Liberable. Thank you so much to Yasin from CPI. Dude, you are awesome. Thank you for sending this car out to me. I really, really appreciate it. We got a bit of bug splatter on here, but I hope you can clean that off. So I'm so sorry about that. But yeah, I'll leave CPI's information all in the description box below. You guys can check them out. This car is incredible, and I mean, look at the damn thing. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, share with friends and family. Check CPI out in the description box below. Be free, be you, live forever, out.